Hello everyone, welcome back to our channel. Today, we will see how to install Trellix ePO on an on-premises application server. Before we begin installing Trellix ePO, let's quickly review the prerequisites. First, you will need a supported Windows Server operating system with enough CPU, memory, and disk space to match your environment scale. Large organizations should allocate higher resources to ensure stable performance. Second, Trellix ePO requires Microsoft SQL Server for its database, along with SQL Server Management Studio to manage it. If you don't already have SQL Server installed, I have created a dedicated video that walks you step-by-step through installing SQL Server 2019 Express and SSMS 21. For large organizations, SQL Server 2019 Express wouldn't be recommended. You would need to have a standard SQL Server license. Finally, make sure that your required network ports are open. This table shows the ports needed by Trellix ePO on-prem for communication through a firewall. Please make sure you allow these ports in your firewall so that your Trellix ePO and the endpoints communicate with each other without any issues. The next step is downloading the ePO installer. Open up a tab in your browser and search for Trellix product downloads. Hit on the first link which says product downloads and you will be redirected to a login page. You have to log in to the official Trellix support portal using your credentials. Post login, you will land up on a page similar to this. Select Management Solutions on the right. Click on Trellix ePolicy Orchestrator. And then filter with installation. Hit on this link which says Install ePolicy Orchestrator Service. This is the base version for your ePO, which was released in 2023. Post installing this base version, we will update it to the latest available update, which is Service Pack 1 Update 5. Let's download it. The base installer download is completed. I will also download the Service Pack 1 Update 5. Let's go to our Downloads folder. So this is our base installer and this is the update. Let's extract the base installer. Once extracted, we have to run the setup.exe file as an administrator. So now we have the Trellix ePO installation wizard, which will guide us through the next steps. I don't have an existing ePO database snapshot, so I'll skip this and move on to the next page. Over here, you can see a directory location, which is the default install directory location for Trellix ePO. If you would like to change the default install location, you can go ahead and change it, but I will leave it to its default. Moving on to the next page. In this page, you have to fill in your database information. In my case, my database server is this. The database name, I'll leave it as it is. The domain, I don't have a domain configured with this server, with this Windows server. If you have a domain configured, you can choose your domain. Since it's in a workgroup environment, it just lists the host name of this Windows server. So I'll select the host name of this Windows server. For now, for this install wizard to connect your database, I'll go with Windows authentication. So I'll enter the username and password for my Windows account. Click on next. Okay, we have an error. So the error says that setup is unable to access the SQL UDP port 1434. Click on OK and go to SQL Configuration Manager. And let's go to Network Configuration Protocols. So you have TCP or IP in a disabled state. Let's enable it. So any changes made will be saved. However, they will not take effect until the service is stopped and restarted. So let's click on OK. Now the TCP or IP is enabled. However, we might need to restart the SQL services. So let's restart the SQL services here. It's done. Just restarting the services which are already in a running state. Okay, we are good to go. And let's click on next again in the installation wizard. So now it proceeds further. There's no problems. There is only one warning which says that there are some pending file renaming operations. So there's only one warning in total. So this window which you see here is a pre-installation auditor. It does a pre-check on your Windows server to confirm if your installation would be successful or not. If it doesn't throw any error, then we are good to proceed with installation. Here we have only one warning. That warning says check for any pending file renaming operations which might require system restart. So it just says it's a warning. We can ignore the warning and then proceed further. These are the required ports which we saw, which needs to be opened in the firewall. Clicked on next, proceed further. Okay, in this page, we have to enter the username and the password which we would like to use to log into the Trellix ePO console. And I'll enter the password, the username, I'll leave it as this. It's admin by default. And this is the recovery passphrase. I'll enter a recovery passphrase as well. And you have to enter your license key for Trellix ePO. And the product downloads page, where you have downloaded your installers, right? So in the home page, after you log into the product downloads, your license key would be available. You can copy and paste that license key in this installation wizard, post which the installation gets started. So I've entered the license key and I've clicked on next, post which you will be presented with end user license agreement. You can go through the end user license agreement and then click on accept to proceed with installation. The next page, I would click on this checkbox to allow Trellix to collect system and software telemetry data. And I'll click on install. This installation takes some minutes to complete. Let's wait for the installation to complete. Trellix ePO installation is now completed. It asks me if I want to launch the ePO console. I click on yes. Let's click on finish. So it opens up the console and Internet Explorer. I'll copy the URL and then close the Internet Explorer. Let me launch Chrome in the new tab. Let me paste the URL. So now we have the ePO console. We have to enter the username and password. Click on sign in. On the first login, we'll be redirected to this page where you see it's called automation and product installation status. So it says installed 45, not installed 5. And based on the products which you have purchased, your products will be listed here. And that's what is called as licensed products. You can now navigate to software catalog. Software catalog is a catalog where you can choose to install products so that you can manage them, push those products to your endpoints, and then secure your environment. So you would have noticed an error in the login page that it says the following extensions are disabled because they are not compatible with the server, the content feed. So to get rid of this warning message or error, you can click on sign in, and then you can go to extensions. You can find the component which says it's incompatible and you can click on remove and click on OK. So this removes that particular content feed extension from extensions list. And now if you go to your login page, you will not have that error. In the next episode, we will walk through how to validate if all ePO services are running correctly, check if the SQL database connection is active, and how to upgrade Trellix ePO to SP1 Update 5. Thank you for watching. Don't forget to subscribe and continue with the playlist for the full learning journey.